Social Dilemma
the
is
Social Dilemma.
It's a show that's been that's gotten some hype over the kind of content it has, and I actually made some notes while I watched half of it because I want to do an actual review.
That's nice. I didn't make any notes because the thing is, for the past 1 year, like I guess when my 12th was over and joined college, I always kind of knew this because my social media time was 2 hours per day, Instagram page. And midway through this scrolling process, I was like, I know there is no interesting content here because it's been garbage up until now. And I was like, why am I scrolling this much? And so I did some research, and so these companies make it really hard to find this information because it's against their business interests. So
absolutely,
they'll put SRK, social media doesn't do anything, whatever, it's garbage, the research papers are garbage and stuff. But if you try hard enough, you can find anything you want on the internet. And there were a lot of speculations kind of how these companies are doing is they use machine learning to mine what you like. And that is why part of the reason why all the feeds went from chronological to algorithmic.
Algorithmic, yeah, absolutely.
It's because the algorithmic one makes you scroll more anyway, and it keeps you engaged more, so they can show you more ads. Although chronological kabhi, there are the losses if someone keeps on spamming, they'll cut top it.
Right. So that
so
essentially the
solution is a mix of both of them.
Exactly. Right. Essentially, it's
It was
easier for creators to hack the chronological algorithm than it is for them to hack this present one right now, because the present one actually
keeps changing kafi zyada.
It keeps changing. The base of it is the same. Ki matlab pehle creators could just spam content with zero production value. There's absolutely no point of the content banane ke liye bana rahe, and they could get the likes and followers and shit mil jata. But today the algorithm actually takes into consideration whether people are liking your content, whether people are engaging with your content. So so creators have been forced to add some kind of value to the content. Well, look, they can't just put out random shit that makes no sense. They have been forced to take up a niche style of content, and then they have been forced to make people like it. They have been forced to give some value and up their production level, essentially. So that's something good.
What these companies then realized is, if they make the algorithm in such a way that you're getting a good post, and there's a dopamine hit you get when you see a good post, you like it, then they'll show you some garbage posts, and as soon as you're going to leave the app, they'll show you another good post. You keep sticking. And the length of the scroll increases. Since the length is increasing,
smart,
they can put more ads in it, and then they get more money out of it. And this becomes a cycle. And I think Twitter does it less than Facebook. I'm not sure about this.
Twitter is I haven't been quite able to figure out Twitter's algorithm yet. I mean, it's very different from Instagram, and
but Twitter has, in my opinion, the people I follow on Twitter are very less, and they're influential people. Like, they don't put garbage anyway. So the problem only arises when you follow a lot of people.
Absolutely.
And a lot of them are garbage and a few are nice.
Absolutely.
So you try and look for the nice content in all the garbage noise that your other following people have.
Yeah.
Twitter, I follow less amount of people, so there's less garbage, and there's just more good content.
Exactly.
So if
that's
you
good.
Want to kind of hack the algorithm, what I did
Absolutely.
Is I have created an alternate Instagram account where I just follow the people I like, influencers and stuff. And then since these guys don't post a lot, but they post quality content.
That's smart.
So I just scroll through that account instead of scrolling through my main account, and it's done.
Genius.
Then he posts karenge koi.
Genius. That's
genius.
Right.
Although, since I've done that, I've gotten a lot of notifications. Since you like this, you might like that. Since you like
this, because it's a new account, I'm guessing, and you're not following a lot of people.
Exactly. So they want you to follow a lot of
people.
Yeah, of
course.
Because they get more advertising dollars out of it.
Exactly.
So
it's like that.
Android made it hard to do this. I don't know about iOS, I haven't checked it, but Android has this feature where you can disable a certain kind of notification.
Nice.
So as soon as I get the, if you like this, this notification, I click on it and I disable the
notification. Right, perfect. Exactly.
So there's that. So you, there are ways around it, it's just hard to figure out.
True.
Even when you do that, the chances of you spending a lot of time is very high, because what these services have done is, like Instagram, at least, we are mostly going to talk about Instagram because that is where I'm more active or at be now.
Yes. Also, the social dilemma also focuses on photo sharing applications. It has a club.
Like Instagram or
Instagram, but yeah, they showed the example of like a photo sharing app, tagging app essentially.
Yeah. That's okay, the story, man.
Yeah, in the story, there's a sort of story.
Social dilemma also goes into the fake news fact. We'll go there in a minute because
that's good. My mother pochani, okay,
but so. The reason you spend a lot of time scrolling through Instagram is, if even if you disable Instagram, the thing is that Instagram has this DMs feature, and all these addictive apps, what they do is they'll put a DM feature in it, and since you can't miss DMs because they've got people texting you, you can't disable the apps or disable all the notifications.
Important.
Because I communicate on Instagram sabse jyada. I don't have a lot of WhatsApp communication skills. But Instagram, pe there are posts coming in and stuff happening. So I can't completely disable the notifications. And as soon as you go into the DMs, the only way out of the app is scrolling back, which is through the feed. And as soon as you see the feed, your favorite creator has a new story. Then you start one story and you just keep scrolling through stories.
Absolutely.
Or keep scrolling through the posts. So a separation of these apps would be better. It just is clear. Oh, but that is not happening at all, because the only reason Instagram thrives is because it allows you to connect people, share posts and stuff. Like, you don't have to change apps to share content there. So that's a plus side. A solution I was thinking about is putting the chat feature in there and then manually being able to switch to feed whenever we want. So that's one way of reducing the addiction, but that is against Facebook business.
Samjhane mein what you're saying.
So, abhi when you open the app, you're greeted with the feed and you need to go to DMs.
Right.
If you click on DMs directly, the way to go out is through feed.
Through the feed.
Like
okay.
You can press the home button, but most of the back button.
Yeah, of course.
I guess,
Definitely.
So, I was watching Social Dilemma, I was also thinking about how to solve this problem.
Yeah.
So one way I came
That's how a coder says, thinks, guys. How to solve the problem. That's how we think.
So one way I thought about it is, as soon as you open that, you're greeted with DMs. And if you want to see the feed, the navigation bar hota hai usme.
So you can switch, the button will switch between feed and chat.
I guess. Yeah, udhar bhi feed ka ye rahega.
That's cool.
Although that will just tank Facebook income.
Obviously,
100%. That's not happening.
Exactly, they want you to spend more time on their app. They don't want you to go away, essentially. Yeah, and creators are also awarded for making people. That's another thing. Yeah, if your content makes someone stay on the app longer, you are awarded with more reach, essentially.
Exactly. That is why if you post a link in some story or something like that, that story is not dealt with.
It won't be pushed. It won't be pushed, essentially.
It's penalized by the recommender system.
Exactly. And
I don't want to care. I exactly know the formulas they use, like mathematical formulas they use to do all this. I just don't want to get into it.
Right.
Way more
But do it's worked with recommender just, systems?
Kind of. Jada detail, I don't know a lot.
Basic.
It's just theory.
Right.
So how it's done is, there is a mathematical formula.
It takes factors into
kitna likes hai, kitna bada description hai, kitna posts hai.
Right.
How are these posts, previous history. And there is this, it's all multiplied with a P. P is the short form for penalty. The mathematical formula, it will sum up all this. And the penalty is calculated depending upon the business interest of the company. So they can set penalties.
Nice.
And it also depends upon multiple factors, like if there is a link in there which is redirecting to outside platforms, so they'll penalize it more.
Samjha.
Like TikTok did it with I don't know, with Hong Kong ka content. China made it. So what happened was China did it. So whenever they saw Hong Kong or some term like that, they just
उसका रीच बंद कर
दे, जस्ट पेनलाइज इट मोर.
बराबर, मतलब यू गेट नो रीच फॉर इट, एसेंशियली कोई दिखता नहीं
कंटेंट. हां, बिकॉज़ द रिकॉर्ड द रिकमेंड दिस सिस्टम डज इज इट कांट सी पोस्ट लाइक वी डू, ऑल इट कैन सी इज नंबर्स.
राइट, एग्जैक्टली.
सो दे अटैच दैट रिकमेंडर फीड का एक नंबर टू इट एंड जस्ट इट्स असेंडिंग, इट्स डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर विद इट, हायर नंबर टू लोअर नंबर.
बराबर.
सो सिंस द पेनल्टी इज मोर, पेनल्टी इज इन 0.001 है सर, तो स्कोर कम होता है एक्चुअली.
Yeah,
so if there is a high penalty, the score is lower. So your post will be lower anyway.
Right.
As descending order. So that is how it works.
My God.
So that is the sad part. Like, these companies have the power to control our opinions. And coming to that, these recommender systems, they are one of the bigger problems. They were made to help us. It's just a side effect of a tech that is misused.
It's a knife with two sides. It's a double-edged sword.
It's double-edged sword. So the reason these recommender systems are hurting us, so essentially, no one, when they were making social media, they never thought that this would be the main channel of news. All they wanted to do was share posts and stuff, like funny videos and stuff. And what happened was, these recommender systems were made in such a way that if you like something, it will just show you this. It will form a walled garden around
you. God. It's called an echo chamber that these recommender systems
create. Echo chamber. Exactly. And what happens is, if there is a news story, and if you like reading news stories where, for example, something is happening.
Let's make it specific. You like reading news. So, for example, your political inclination is left, okay? You're a leftist. You're a liberal.
That's the best example.
You're a liberal, right? Exactly.
So I don't know what liberal and...
It's completely fine. Left and right. There's liberal and this conservative.
So if you like... If you like just leftist news, leftist both, right?
Leftist.
If you just like that kind of news, it will just surround you with that. And the right will seem so bad that because you aren't receiving the good news from this side.
Exactly.
You're just receiving good news from this side and all the bad news from this side.
Yeah.
And what this has created is, I think we can put the graphs here to the social dilemma. But we as humans have separated so much recently.
Yeah. Oh my God. Right. I saw the graph growing apart. Yeah. It's like it was a graph of overlapping thought systems. And
what they asked left ko right ke bare mein, how they feel about them, and right ko left ko right.
Yeah.
And the views have gotten so extreme.
Extremely different.
It's because what has happened is they have just seen the good news khud ke side and they've seen just the
bad news samne walon ke side ka. That's what it's called.
It's not their mistake, but they are shown that.
Yeah. They are not shown any other perspectives there, which is actually kind of problematic if you ask me, because I was talking to my mom the other day and we were debating. We were having a pretty mature debate. We don't usually do that. But we were debating over the concept of maturity. And I told her a person who has a lot of perspective, there's chances that he is way more mature in a general sense. If a social media app is not giving you different, it is stopping you from getting different perspectives just to fuel their own capitalistic greed, then I think that's definitely problematic.
But
they are showing you content that you like.
But it's a side effect, it's not what they intended.
लोग ये सोच के एल्गोरिथम नहीं बना, बट इट हैज टर्न्ड आउट दैट वे अल्टीमेटली.
एंड द सैड पार्ट इज दे नो दिस.
हां,
तो ऑफ कोर्स दे नो दिस एको चेंबर थिंग इज हैपनिंग. टिकटॉक इवन एक्नॉलेज्ड इट, आई गेस, थोड़े दिन पहले. द सैड पार्ट इज द ओनली वे टू फिक्स दिस इज टू टर्न देम ऑफ.
either
and
to
take a more human approach to it.
This also reminded me of, I'm gonna most probably make a video on this on my own channel, but it reminded me of this. If you've read Amish's books, right, Amish Tripathi, he's essentially the Rick Riordan of India. Okay, so matlab wo Hindu myths ko leta hai. So far he's done Hindu myths only, and he gave them a scientific sort of turn, right? He's reimagined them. He has apni khud ki creativity editing karke, matlab usne, he's essentially rewritten it from a more scientific point of view. ठीक है, अमिश त्रिपाठी, the Shiva trilogy and the Ramchandra series. तो
it's just the book with the cover पे ऐसा Shiva का ये रहता है, the texture is different Shiva पे.
Yeah.
It may be
exactly. It's fine. So what he has, the essential learning of the Shiva trilogy is that the biggest good of any say generation, right, it is bound to become the biggest evil a few generations later. Samjha?
Oh.
In their case, I don't want to spoil it, but in their case it was that, and that is again what I'm seeing in this generation. Like, the internet was the biggest boon, the biggest gift, I think 20 years ago, and then just 20 years later, not even a generation later, just 20 years, I mean, it's barely there. India ka bas internet hai bhi nahi, and it's already one of the biggest evils that we have out there.
But then that's the thing, right? Whenever something new emerges without any regulation, okay, take the examples of cars, okay? When cars were invented, that was the best thing ever. But
exactly.
There was no regulation to them.
Right.
So accidents happened a lot. There were no roads, there were no signals and stuff. And you can't imagine your life without cars right now, I guess. Yeah, I mean,
can't.
Of course.
You can't.
But imagine tabhi what they would have done is, in cars were causing accidents, which is cars banned karte the. That would have been devastating. So we can't just ban the internet, or we can just
turn off the internet now.
We have to regulate it.
It's not practical. We have to regulate. And the thing is, there's no government bodies who are going to do it for you. There's no corporations who are going to do it for you.
What these government bodies are doing is they'll just shut off the internet, or
that's stupid.
Shut off whatever they don't.
That's
and
not good.
The problem is, these government is made by humans, see. So even they are affected with this problem, and they are the most influential people who are affected by this problem.
Exactly.
So if they think that way, we are all screwed anyway.
Absolutely.
So
the regulators, the people who need to regulate, who need to consciously work on negating these or battling these algorithms, is ourselves. Like, we have to do it ourselves. Unless you take an initiative to limit your, to unfollow pages that you don't like or don't give you value, if you unfollow these pages, if you unfollow pages which
but
teach you nothing new,
it can form an even bigger echo chamber if you unfollow pages that don't like. So
who don't give you any value, I'm saying. At the end of the day,
okay,
if
that
they
makes sense.
Don't teach you anything, if you're wasting your time, I feel all content should give you some amount of value. That's my end goal. That's why I was never into TikTok, right? Because that content rarely gave me any value, and jo value de sakta tha, I mean, there were good pages on TikTok which spread awareness and which taught you a lot of stuff, but I was getting my information from YouTube anyway, so I did not feel the need to go onto that platform. That's an example.
Thing, if you're taking news for information, please, now is the worst time to take it from social media. Fact check everything you see. If you see 2+2 on social media, go and fact check if it's 4.
True, man. Holy shit. We'll have to do that in the future sometime. Again, you're making another reference to one of the books that I've read, where it's George Orwell books. It's called 1984, where it's a very dystopian future where there is thought police, like not THOT, not thought. Wo aaj exist kar rahe. Thought police essentially, and it's about a story. It's a story of a man who was working for this character, apparently. They never show the character. The antagonist is apparently Big Brother, okay? And the antagonist is never shown. We don't know if he exists. Okay? He exists only in paper, in voice recordings. Okay, we don't know who Big Brother is. And he is essentially the dictator. he determines what the law is, and all the social media, all the books, essentially they reflect what he says is true. Samjha?
Oh,
so the
non-courageous,
the protagonist is actually works for the for Big Brother in the ministry, and his work is to change the past. Samjha, his work is to change all the accounts. He has to change dates. He has to change what people said in the books that people read from. That's his work, and it's his journey from go from there to realizing that Big Brother is a scam to finally submitting to him. Like, they teach him that 2 plus 2 is 5 and not 4, and they prove it to him.
I haven't read the book, but I guess
So again, you're making a reference to a book. I'm sorry, another time change. It went on.
I haven't read the book, sorry, but yeah, fact checked. And the only way to save yourself from this is fact checking everything. See, whatever, if a scene happens, some incident happens, there's a high chance ki it is more neutral than you think. The reason why extremism has taken effect is because it's the cool, it's what attracts viewers, it attracts attention.
Extremism, that's the word. Good one, Abhay.
And okay, this is a completely made up story and it's not true and stuff. I just made it up right now. Imagine a story where someone is suicidic building se kood gaya, okay? It's very sad. That pulls some views. Now imagine if her mom tries to save her, but she jumps anyway. That's a thodu news. Okay? Mom tries to save daughter, she jumps anyway. Mom pushes daughter from building.
Oh bhai. My god.
Uska views the.
Nice.
That's what's happening. And your headline may hoga ki mom pushes daughter. And people just read the headline. Social media pe wo headline hi hota hai, highlight hota hai.
Right.
And the news story will be like, mom tries to save her, but looks like she is pushing her in the video. And she, what actually what's happening is she's trying to save her. And wo sab news article mein likha hai. So the news site are technically telling the truth. It's just that they're
but headline, but right.
And people just take the headline.
Absolutely.
And so, niche ke story mein, it's all truth. Ki she was trying to save her, but she jumped anyway. But that is not taken. That is not the cool. That is not what's picked up by social media. Because social media is short term. It's just
absolutely.
You want the news in 3 seconds.
That's a good example. That's a good example.
But yeah, that's the problem. And this is happening everywhere. What I said.
100%
The story isn't true, but the concept is what's happening.
Concept is very true. It's happening today. And you know it. I mean, if you're watching this podcast, you're privileged enough to be open to a lot of content out there. And you're probably aware. If you're not, it's time to get aware. It's time to get uninjured.
Exactly.
Holy shit.
You can't just say that that's not happening.
Exactly.
But
so,
yeah, someone has to work on a fix.
That was a social dilemma. That was a social dilemma. Watch it on Netflix. It'll teach you a lot of stuff and you should probably reform your social media habits.
I think you should watch it on Netflix.
Yeah, I think...
Okay. Coming back to the people who don't have Netflix. Please don't pirate it. Because that's the thing. The proceeds to that, okay, some part of it will go to Netflix, but some part of it... part of it will go to all the people who made that possible.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
and they're taking a big step towards it because going against Mark Zuckerberg, Facebook, and stuff.
Exactly. I was like, how is this
hard?
How is this allowed on Netflix? How are they doing this? Like the employees.
The irony of it being on Netflix is like your
cocaine
dealer warning you about the effects of marijuana.
अरे वो cigarette पाता ना tobacco use cancer वैसा.
Netflix addiction is also a thing. Netflix won't cover it. Netflix, I think, made sure they are not part of this. But you don't receive news from Netflix.
That's okay. I mean, they have algorithms to keep you on their site anyways. But it's not as bad on Netflix.
What these social media sites have done is they have advertised. They haven't necessarily advertised, but they became the tools we require for everyday communication. But what this document, it's completely coming from the documentary, I haven't made this stuff up. But what the documentary is, it's at a simple line. A tool doesn't bug you continuously to use it. A tool is like a bicycle.
It just lies there for you to use it.
It's there when you need it. And it works perfectly every time. it doesn't come up to you, bugging you to use it. And I hope your bicycle doesn't do that. But yeah, someone has to make a social media that is actually a tool. And yeah, I guess I really need you guys to watch The Social Dilemma. Poof. That's the one thing you should watch on Netflix.